more in costs. What a massive loss for our small businesses across Europe. Our findings when drawing up this report demonstrated that mediation is a very valuable tool for consumers and businesses, and I think the message today to Member States is that they need to do more to promote the benefits of mediation. They should provide more training for mediators, encourage the drawing up of voluntary codes of conduct, and I believe this is the case because best practice in mediation shows that across Europe there is a 70% success rate with mediation cases. In fact, it's 80% if the parties voluntarily choose mediation, but still only 1% of parties are taking up mediation in Europe. Again, the figures speak for themselves. Going through the courts took on average an extra 331 to 446 days and extra legal costs of 12,000 to 13,000 euros to solve a case. The experience in my own member state is that litigation worth 200,000 euros took 333 days, costing on average 51,000 euros, where mediation would have taken a mere 87 days and cost a fraction at 9,000 euros. One mediator told me that last year he mediated 115 disputes in the UK. Within 1 week he solved those, and 30 were cross-border. Mediation is therefore a flexible, speedy and cost-effective way to resolve disputes. It allows the parties greater control, it gives them more responsibility in resolving their disputes, and I believe it's especially beneficial in family disputes concerning children, because of course it can dramatically shorten the period of time required to reach agreement, and this is better for their well-being and reduces anxiety, conflict and stress in the family. To quote another very convincing case, a dispute over an estate and will worth £10 million involving four parties, three jurisdictions, the UK, Switzerland and France, was solved by a mediator in 1 day. But by the time they got to mediation, €5 million had already been swallowed up by the courts and lawyers across three different EU states. And of course it would have taken another 2 years to try and solve this problem in court. So today I want to encourage the Commission and Member States to continue to strengthen and implement the EU law and give consumers and businesses an alternative to costly legal disputes. Given the number of disputed property cases we have in the EU, I would also like to use today as an opportunity to ask the Commission and Member States to make more use of mediation systems to assist our constituents in disputes such as the numerous cases we have in Spain and Cyprus. Establishing mediation procedure to bring an end to these costly and lengthy disputes will, of course, increase these citizens' access to justice. To conclude, we are largely satisfied with the work of the Member States in implementing this law, albeit at the time of drafting only 17 Member States have EU rule place, and we welcome, Commissioner Reding, the fact that you are starting infringement proceedings against 9 Member States. We note that some Member States have gone further than the EU guidelines, but we do hope that our committee report, based on practitioners and users' views, will provide useful input so that we can better serve our citizens with an affordable and efficient system for access to justice. Thank you.
Thank you very much, Mrs. McCarthy. Now let me call Commissioner Reding.
President, thank you, and I would like to thank most of all the rapporteur because she has presented a very comprehensive report on something which I believe could be a wonderful alternative to court cases. You know that the access to justice is a cornerstone of the European area of justice, but here with mediation we have an important alternative to going court in a cross-border dispute and to help us for amicable settlements. As the rapporteur says so rightly, it saves money, time and spares the parties involved in family cases also additional trauma of going to court. Mrs. McCarthy's report provides a political assessment on the way some member states have implemented the provision of the directive. I agree with the rapporteur that we have to aim at a strict application of the provisions, and I am pleased that through this report probably more member states will go for a smooth application, because you are right, rapporteur, not all member states have put in place measures